Monday. That means it's time for 5-Minute Art. I hope you are having a fantastic week. I have had a good week. It's been super busy, lots of orders, lots of things in the works right now, which is kind of exciting. I can't wait to tell you what might be happening. But I just want to say one thing. I want you to know how incredibly thankful I am for you and your support. Your words, your encouraging words, your comments when you buy a piece of art, it just means so much, so much. It allows me to do what I love and to be able to encourage and to give hope and maybe some insight or something on a daily basis. But I just want you to know how thankful I am for you and for all that you do for me. So, with that said, let's get into today's art. Ta-da! I love this piece. I like it all every week. It's like, oh, my favorite piece. But I love the colors. It's springy. It's vibrant. It's bright. It's got a great message. It's titled, There's Courage Here in the Middle. But it says, It Takes Courage to Let Go. And I talk a little bit about that in the video. My little message to you. So anyway, I just want you to know that I'm thankful for you. You are loved, and let's get started. All right. Hey everybody, welcome back to 5-Minute Art. It is Monday and we've got a really cool piece that we're going to be doing today. Anyway, this is my MDF board. It is an 8x10. And what I've done right now is I just put this piece of paper onto my MDF board. It was a regular old piece of scrapbook paper that I found, but I loved it because it's that old eye chart looking thing. So I loved it. I love how it looks. It's got some scribbles on it and some aging. So it is already on my MDF board. I put it down with matte medium. And we're ready to go. Let's rock and roll. So, I found this scrapbook paper. It and this piece too are by Afternoon Muse and it's Glitz Design. But I love the shading. And so we're gonna be working from this color palette for today's piece. We'll also use a couple of these like a strip of it, along with a few others from the same maker, same color palette. I love that. So, anyway, right now these colors we're going to kind of lay down on our background and work from there. So I'm pulling out just a bunch of different colors in along that same color line. So I've got some orange, I've got some aqua, or this is, that's not the right one, aqua, some green, and so let's see what else, oh, pink, I need some like rose pink, hot pink, some rose pink, and this one, I'm dropping everything, that one, I think. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my credit card and just kind of drag randomly. And I'm actually also going to use my fingers and kind of rub it in a little bit. So I'm going to take these colors and just go for it. Color And it looks pretty random right now, and that's okay. I want it to be that way. But if I go back to my inspiration colors, yeah, baby, that looks good. So now what I'm gonna do, I got a couple spots that aren't quite dry. All right, now I am going to take some buttermilk, putting it over here on my palette. And what I want to do is cover this entire piece with that buttermilk. The reason I do this is it acts like a filter. You know, when if you're doing Instagram or on your phone, you have all these filters that kind of gives it a grainy feeling. That's what I'm going for. You want that toned down feeling, just like this piece of paper. It looks a little grungy and soft and muted, like there's paint over it. That's the purpose of me doing the white on top of here. It just tones everything down. Done and dry, and it just tones that down. It makes it feel really soft. You still get the vibrancy of the colors, but it's just a little bit muted, so that it's got an aged effect. So right now, I'm going to set this aside for a sec, and I want to prepare the rest of the papers that are going to be going on the piece, which means I have a couple. So some really great scrapbooking papers. I just love, love, love the colors. And here's another one. This is a burlap one, light and dark on both sides. I'm gonna be using all of these, as well as this one. I love it. Both sides are just done and ready for me to apply the matte medium, but I'm not yet done with prepping the papers. So this piece here is actually going to be used for, I'm going to scoot that down, for the heart. And I'm going to use this piece right here. And I'm going to be painting the heart on there, and I want to be able to, as I'm painting it, I want it to be transparent enough that you can see the cool things that are happening underneath. The way that we do that is I've got on my palette here, I've got my pinks that I'm going to be using. I'll probably use the darker. I might mix them. I might even add a touch of red. But to keep it transparent, that's what the matte medium does. So I'm going to be putting a little bit of the matte medium over here. And as I start mixing, I'm going to be dipping into the matte medium. And that'll help it give it some longevity so I can move it around and blend it. And it makes it transparent so it's soft and you'll be able to see what's happening underneath. All right, so let's go. All right, that is down and dry. And now we're gonna add a little oomph to the wings. Cause I mean, if you get them just like you want them, that's awesome. But very seldom can I find one that I it's perfect just the way that it is. So
we're gonna jazz it up a bit using my colors over here on my color palette, or on my palette I should say. I'm just gonna go in. I've got a tiny brush. Lightly highlight certain areas. And now, what I want to do is I want to start our aging process. So I am taking my charcoal. This is umber. And I'm just going to start going around my edges. So I've gone over my piece with the umber, and now I'm going to go back in with my charcoal pencil, sharper one, and I'm just going to add some further dimension with the black. Okay, so I've gone in and I've added my black and just shaded around a lot of the edges. Again, like I did with the brown. It just adds a little extra depth to your piece. I'm going to take this outside and spray it with my fixative, and then I will be right back. Okay, this has been sprayed. It's done. With the shading and everything. And now we're going to start adding our words and some additional texture. So this week's inspiration, I was going through one of my many books. This is by Michelle Standler. It's called Courage Doesn't Always Roar, and it's kind of a story with some beautiful artwork. But one of the things that really struck me was it takes courage to let go of your assumptions and fly to your dreams. And I think so often sometimes we get caught in a place, I know I do, I'll speak for me. I get caught in a place where I think that I've always been a certain way, or this is the way that I am, or this is my personality, whatever. And to really grow and to change, gosh, it's hard. It takes courage to let go of some ideas, maybe some other dreams that you thought were important, but now it's changed. Change happens, and we grow in those times. And it's so hard to let go of some things and to really fly and soar to where you want to be. And so that's the inspiration for this piece. I hope today that you are able to look into your heart of hearts and find your dreams and really go for it. Really take some steps, whether they're small or big or whatever, but that you really search out your dreams, your passions, your desires, and take some steps in that direction. It's amazing what happens to you in the process. And it might not always go the way that you think that it's supposed to go. It never does. But the process is what is so amazing. So it's my word for you today. Go for it. So in the middle here, we're going to do courage. And then down here, I'm just going to put right in, it takes courage to let go. So that's the process of what will be happening next, okay? And I'm going to do that with some of my letter stamps. Letters are done. So I've got courage in here. It takes courage to let go. And it is dry. I've dried it. And now I'm going to highlight some of the letters. I'll probably, you know, do my signature little thing here. Okay, so I've highlighted and shaded around the letters a little bit and smudged that. I'm loving, love the colors of this. I love the heart. Now, I'm going to take a few things and start adding a little grunge, a little texture to it. And I'm going to be using, because we've got plenty of color on there, so I'm going to be using my umber and just going to take my umber and put that on there like that. Get it on there pretty good, pretty nice and thick. Okay, got all of our yummy goodness texture in there. Some are a little darker, some are a little lighter. I love it though. I don't want to do any more. So my temptation is to keep going and do stuff. I'm going to paint the sides black, and we are done.